You got to stand on what you stand on out here. Do you feel me? Now, unfortunately, not everybody standing on what they stand on are really that solid. For example, if you're delusional, if you're not really tapping in with yourself and have an understanding of where you truly at, what are you standing on? Do you feel me? And on top of all that, you have people around you that's allowing you to stand on what you stand on, knowing that's not the right way to go. Knowing that you about to walk into a burning building. Do you feel me? You got to stand on what you stand on out here, but also know what you're standing for. Do you feel me? Because like I said in my other videos, you have to have the qualifications to speak on certain situations. You have to have the criteria for you to be able to have that type of mantle, to have that type of responsibility, to have that type of understanding to lead your people, to lead your community, to lead your household. Do you feel me? So you have to stand on what you stand on, but understand what that is. Do you feel me? Know what I mean? I'm giving y'all that sauce. Hit that subscribe button right now. Sean B. Stoll is the name. Hit that subscribe button. We about to go in. You have to know what you're standing on and stand on that. Now, the flip side to that as well. Maybe it's not the most pretty situation. Maybe you know that at the end of this, I may not even see the finishing touches of what I'm laying down. But the key to this is you know what you're striving for. You know what your end game is. You know what you're trying to get to, whether it's for you or for your family. Do you feel me? You have to stand on what you stand on out here, but understand what that is. Understand what the consequences is. And that leads me into the Kanye West. And I'm really, you know, I'm not looking forward to have this conversation because I don't want my channel to be just loaded up with, you know, talking about somebody else all day. That ain't me. I'm a little under the weather, but we rocking. So with Kanye West, you know, they say he a billionaire, multi-billionaire. Now that he lost the Adidas deal, you know, a couple of major big endorsers, you know what I'm saying? He lost those deals. Velocity was that, you know, a few of them. I can't pronounce the name. That's not important. I mean, it's already on the internet, so you can find out. But my thing is this, when it comes to Kanye West. Or my bad, Ye. You know what I'm saying? He changed his name to Ye, so let me get it correct. Ye. So my response to Ye with his current, you know, conversation that he said about how, you know, these companies releasing him or terminating the contract. This goes back to what I said in one of my last videos, your digital reputation. See, the key to this, my personal opinion is, When you go on these rants and you say all these things about slavery, about the Jewish community and all these different things, you have to understand what that comes with. You know? Because not everybody is going to agree to what you're saying. And on top of all that, you are an influencer. You know, a lot of people love your music, your clothing, you know, probably even your family situation, just the dynamic of how y'all, you know, multimillionaires, billionaire situation, you know, how y'all making it work, whether you with, you know, Kim Kardashian or not, you know, y'all still making it work. to a degree of what I see on the internet. So what I'm trying to say is this. When you have, you know, the public ear, the public eye, when you say certain things, when you release certain type of videos, you know it's going to go way beyond the average viewer, the average listener. Do you feel me? You have to understand that comes with a reputation. That comes with a standard. That comes with a terms and conditions. Do you feel me? See, that's what I'm saying, man. All my videos I've been giving y'all, it all ties in and correlate to this type of situation. Because like I keep saying, it doesn't really matter how much money you have. Because at the end of the day, what you stand on is what you stand on. Do you feel me? I mean, you know, it's like, I've been doing pretty well with my life. I mean, I'm not a millionaire. But I can tell you this, when I was a hundredaire and a hundred thousandaire, my core of my standards and what I represent for myself remain the same. Do you feel me? You got to stand on what you stand on out here. Do you feel me? You really got to understand that. There is a terms and conditions. You know, the cell phone you use, the company you work for, the company you keep in your house. Do you bring everybody to your house? No, because most people have a standard for themselves. They don't just invite anybody into their house just because you're a millionaire, just because you're successful. Hey, I just meet you on the street. I haven't verified anything about you. You tell me you're a millionaire and now I'm walking you into my house? No, stop, slow down. You gotta have a standard out here. And that's my whole point with the Kanye. It's like, you know, with the Ye, I'm sorry. With Ye, it's like, okay, you're a billionaire. You say, you know, the richest black man, whatever. That's cool. But just understand what that comes with. Understand that. So when you get out here and you speak, you get out here and say certain things, just know that a lot of eyes, especially the upper echelon, are watching. Now, in America, so many things that fight against you, and you just walking right into a burning building, man. What are you doing? Do you feel me? Now, if that's what you want to do, then stand on that. You know what I'm saying? When you lose these major deals, stand on what you stand on regardless of that, if that's who you truly are. Because looking at your track record, man, you're a little flippy, floppy type dude. You know what I'm saying? One minute it's this, next minute it's that. I mean, I'm trying to figure out where is your standard, man? It ain't my standard, it's your standard. Now, if your standard is to be, you know, very irrational and all over the place, then for me and myself as an individual, I can't support that. I will not support that because I can't be flip-floppity when it comes to me taking care of my family. I can't be flip-floppity when I work for these, you know, for these multi-million dollar companies. When I sign on that dotted line, and they tell me these are the terms and conditions, guess what? I have to meet that. Or our contract is voided. Our contract is terminated. I am fired. Do you feel me? So unless you finna open up your own social media company, unless you about to open up your own manufacturing company, which I understand you are in a degree, you know, you already have the factory, and maybe that's the best way for you at this point. But my question to anybody watching this video, what are your terms and conditions and understanding? Do you feel me? Because I'm getting off the yay. Now we're going to talk about your motivation. because everybody got a lot to say about that man. Let's talk about the man and the one man that's watching this video. Do you feel me? Because it's all about your standard. And like I said in one of my other videos, before you can talk about somebody else, did you clean out your closet? Huh? Did you landscape your house? You know what I'm saying? Did you Clorox your kitchen and your bathroom? Oh, oh my bad, they're doing a recall on that, so you better look out for the Clorox. But you get the point that I'm making. Where is your terms and conditions when it comes to your home, your household, your establishment, your relationships? Do you feel me? Because everybody got a lot to say when it comes to the next man or woman. Now that light is on you. What are you about? Because I can't tell you what a billionaire mindset is. I can't tell you that. I don't know what it comes with. I'm just telling you my experiences and my opinion. But since everybody got something to say, what are your terms and conditions? Do you feel me? You know? Because on my channel, that's what I'm about. I'm about self-motivation. You know, having a standard for yourself. What is your reputation for yourself? Do you feel me? You know? And on top of all that, anybody else that you have in your life, you know? Because when you marry somebody, right, or you committed to somebody, right, you have certain expectations that they have to meet, right? And when you're married on paper, there is a terms and conditions that comes with that. Do you feel me? And we can take it a step further on that. If you get some type of loan, whether it's a home loan, auto loan, personal loan, a business loan, when you sign that dotted line, you are to produce what you agree upon. Do you feel me? So what are your standards? What kind of endorsements do you have that you have to maintain that terms and conditions? See, that's the thing about all this, you know? You know, with yay is one thing. Now, let's figure out what your thing is. Because everybody got something going on. Whether it's positive or negative. So what is your standard? That's what I would like to know. Do you feel me? So hit that subscribe button. You know what I mean? Hit that subscribe button right now. Leave a comment. You can like it. You can share it. It's cool. You know what I mean? And shout out to all my subscribers, man. Shout out to my subscribers. I really appreciate y'all. Y'all really rocking with me. And to anybody else that watched my channel for any length of time, I do appreciate you. Because it's a lot of channels. It's a lot of podcasters you can be. But you're here with me, so I appreciate you. Sean B. Stola, thank you. You feel me? Yeah, I'm a little under the weather. I don't know what's going on. You know, you can hear it in my nose, but we still rocking out. I appreciate y'all. That's why I was like, you know what? I'm not feeling well, but I'm still going to put this video together and put it out for the ones that appreciate my content. Just to let y'all know, I still go hard in the paint. You know what I'm saying? Even though I'm not feeling well, we still gonna rock out, man. And hey, because like I said, I can't be telling anybody about self-motivation. And I'm letting the little nasal condition affect me where I can't get out here and work. Nah, that's not gonna happen. Sean B. Stola, I am a product of my own information that I put out there. I'm a product of my own environment of what I do. Do you feel? So let's keep it going. I ain't done yet. So, and that goes to anything, you know, you can add it into relationship base, you know, it applies there, you know, because if I'm dealing with somebody, especially for, like I said, if I've been with you for a while, you know, whether you're married or not, you have certain expectations that you want that your partner to meet or continue to maintain, you know what I'm saying? Or elevate too. You know, so that's my whole thing is, what is your terms and conditions? You know, even with your family members. You know, if you do something for somebody, they need this from you. Excuse me. And you produced, you did what you were supposed to do. Now they are to be able to do what they were supposed to do. Do you feel me? So what is your terms and conditions out here? Because it's funny, right? You don't mind signing that contract for terms and conditions for your cell phone. You don't mind signing that for some type of membership that you're involved in, whether it's going to the gym, you know, some type of TV service. You don't mind signing that contract, right? So what is your terms and conditions out here? That's the whole question is. Because I know what I stand on. You know, and if you go to my community section, you can see, you know. You see a little bit more about me. I try to put more pictures out there. You can also check out my Instagram, Sean B. Stoller, or Sean Gully, it's the same. But I'm not out here just talking reckless on this microphone. I got to bring something to you. I'm not going to just talk about other people's business all day because it's way too much going on in this world. It's way too much game that need to be given for the ones that want it. That's what I'm here for. You know what I'm saying? So what kind of terms and conditions do you have for yourself? What type of terms and conditions do you have for the ones that's around you? Do you feel me? You know, because you'll let somebody come in, right? You barely know the person. You've invited them over to your house. You know what I'm saying? Eating up all your food. Do you know if they even work? Huh? What is your terms and conditions when it comes to you, huh? Just because they do certain things in the bedroom for you, now they get access to everything? Really? That's all they got to do? But when that PG&E bill come in, right? When that rent is due, right? Huh? Your car payment is late. You need some help with the insurance. Do you feel me? Where is your terms and conditions? Because I'll tell you this. Anybody out here that's working and building on something, I can tell you for the majority of the people, myself included, you don't want to deal with somebody. I don't care how beautiful a woman look. If all she got to offer me is just sex, that's not going to work for me. That, yeah, that'll work for that moment. But over time, that get old, bro. That get old fast. So if you just offer me just one thing, and I got this big business, I'm running my household, I got this business going on, I'm here, I'm there, I need somebody that can actually do things in their life, somebody that can produce things in their life. Do you feel me? I know a lot of people feeling me, especially my fellas, ladies too. But that's my whole thing is, you know, I'm not just going to invite anybody into my house just because you say you're a millionaire and I haven't checked your qualifications. I'm not going to give you my car keys. I don't even know if you have a license. And if you do have a license, how do you drive? Do you feel me? Because how do I know your terms and conditions match my terms and conditions? Do you feel me? You know, so that's the thing you got to really look out here for. You know what I mean? You need to understand what you got going on and what you're building on and how you can implement that with somebody else if it's necessary. Do you feel me? Because when you got something to lose, when you build it on something, you don't want somebody just to come in that easy and tear it down. It may have took you years to get whatever you have. Now, it ain't about value. It's just having an understanding. Like, I'm bringing you to my home. That's my peace. For most people, especially like myself, when I come home, that's my peace area. I'm not trying to fight when I get home. I'm not trying to be with somebody that I feel like that's not beneficial for me in my life, just like I would be for their life. Do you feel me? So that's the thing with me. What is your terms and conditions? Huh? That's what I want to know. What is your terms and conditions, your standards, and what do you stand on? Do you feel me? That's what I want to know. Hold up real quick. Yeah, people making noise over there. I don't like that in my audio, you know. I stay in the condo out here in the Bay. But our front door is just a little bit too close, man. I don't like that. Hopefully, early next year, I'm looking to move into a house, you know, from this location as well. So I'll keep my community section updated if I plan on moving next year, because the housing market is starting to look, you know, definitely in my favor. I've been looking, so I could possibly do an upgrade early next year. So we'll see. But the terms and conditions. What are your terms and conditions out here? Because most people have a whole lot to say about the next man business. But what is your business? What do you stand on? Huh? What is your terms and conditions? So before you run your mouth about the next person, make sure your house is in order. Make sure that what you say, that you stand on, what you about. Do you feel me? You know? Because you got to have a standard and a terms and conditions, man. And I will say this, a lot of people who don't, just look how most of them, their life is so sporadic. Meaning their life is in shambles. They all over the place. Because regardless if you like it or not, the more structure you have, the more successful you have. That's my opinion. Do you feel? You know, so that's a little bit of tip from Mr. Sean B. Stola. I am here. I'm probably going to drop another video later on this evening. But till next time, peace.